हेलो एवरीवन, आई मुनमुन अगेन हियर इन दिस प्लेटफॉर्म टू टीच यू ईवीएस। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू चैप्टर 2, दैट इज रिप्रोडक्शन इन प्लांट्स। फर्स्ट आई वांट टू आस्क यू दैट एवर यू हर्ड दिस टर्म रिप्रोडक्शन, मीन टू से डू यू नो व्हाट इज रिप्रोडक्शन। री मीन्स एनीथिंग दैट हैपनिंग अगेन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, take a word reinstall, that means installing something again. If anyone tell you to repeat any activity, you automatically understand that he or she wants you to do that activity again or more than once, isn't it? Hence, to produce something is called reproduction. Now, same way we can say plant reproduction is the production of new offspring in plants. And the importance of reproduction is that it ensures continuation of similar kind of individual generation after generation. Children, as we know that new plants mostly arise from seeds. Before understanding the process of germination of a seed, let us first understand the structure of a seed through this diagram. A seed has three parts. First one, seed coat. Second one is cotyledon or seed leaves, and third part is embryo. Let us know about them in detail. First one is seed coat. It protects the internal parts of a seed, or you can say the outer protective covering of a seed. Second, cotyledons, the supplier of nutrients or food for the embryo. Third, embryo, it is an immature plant from which a new plant will grow under proper conditions. Now, after knowing the structure of a seed, let us start our main topic of this chapter, that is reproduction in plants. Plants reproduce either through seeds or other plant parts like leaves, roots, stem, etc. First of all, we will learn how a plant reproduces from seeds. A seed grows into a seedling when it receives sufficient amount of water, air and warmth. The process by which a seed develops into a seedling is called germination. Diagram of seed germination is here in your slide. First, you can see embryo, the tiny plants or baby plants. Seed coat, the protective layer. Cotyledon, the food supplier. And foliage leaves, means the leaves, the site of photosynthesis. The development of a seed into a seedling is not a single step process. Before growing into a fully grown plant, a seed has to go through a number of stages. These stages are follows. During germination, the seed absorbs water and the cells of the embryo divide and increase in size. The seed coat then breaks up. First, the root or radical grows downwards. During the early stages of germination, the food required by the growing sapling is provided by the cotyledons, also called seed leaves, which store food for the baby plant. After the food of the cotyledon is used up, seedling then starts absorbing water and nutrients from the soil with its roots, develop leaves and grows into a plant. In spite of the fact that the conditions are favorable for the germination, even then, if many seeds are close to each other, then also all may not survive due to the struggle of air, water, light, nutrient and space to grow. To avoid growing very close to each other, plants take help of agents like wind, water or animals to scatter their seeds. These agents carry the seeds and scatter them away from the parent plant. The process by which the seeds are scattered away from the parent plants is called dispersal. In order to facilitate dispersal by different agents, many seeds and fruit have developed special features. Let us study how these features help them in their dispersal and the mechanism of dispersal of each agent. First is wind. The seeds of plants like cotton, dandelion are very light and have either wings or hair on them. These features enable them to be easily carried away by wind. Second is water. The seeds or fruit of plants growing near or in water are either spongy or fibrous. This enables them to float on water. Water then carries them to different places. For example, coconut and lotus fruit are carried away by water. Animals. Human beings and animals eat fleshy fruit like apples, mango, etc. and throw away their seeds in different places. These seeds germinate into new plants on getting appropriate condition for growth. Some seeds have sticky hair, bristles, hooks or barbs. These get transported by sticking to the fur of animals or even to the clothes of human beings. Fourth one is explosion. Some fruits scatter their seeds by exploding the seed pods. When the seeds are ripe and the pod has dried, it bursts upon and the seeds are scattered. For example, pods of peas, soybean, beans spread their seeds by explosion. Let's recapitulate the topics we have learned today. Number 1, the term reproduction. It means the production of new offspring. Second, importance of the reproduction. It is essential for the continuation of a species. Third, structure of a seed. Seed has three parts: seed coat, cotyledons, and embryo. Fourth, reproduction from seeds. In this, seed grows into a seedling when it's sown in the right type of soil and it receives sufficient amount of water, air, and warmth. The term germination. The process by which seed develops into a seedling. Steps of germination already I discussed in detail. Seventh, the term of dispersal. The process by which the seeds are scattered away from the parent plant is called dispersal. Number 8 is agents of dispersal, and those are wind, water, animals, and explosion. Hope you all understand very well the topics explained here. Thanks for watching.